There are many choices in internet radio, and the staff and host of LA Talk Live would like to thank you for choosing the internet's hottest destination for the most eclectic sound and invigorating talk. This is LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
This is SETD. You are now listening to WC Radio. Stay tuned for more information on LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.
Welcome, welcome. This is WC Radio. I'm your host. I am WDC. I want to thank you for tuning and listening today. I got a great show for my sickle cell community. That's what this platform is about, sickle cell trait and disease. So guess what you got? You got a person with the trait right here, and my teammate is in the building finally. Jody DBC right here is here. Say hello real quick.
Hello, everybody.
You're a little nervous. Hey, just stay tuned for the show. This is my theme song, Young Ice. This is the first verse. It's Curtis Blow, Young Ice and IG the Great. It's on iTunes, 99 cents. Check it out. Curtis Blow.
Basketball is my favorite sport. You know I like the way the dribble up and down the court. Fast and slow. 25 years ago to WDC and it's me, your man, Curtis Blow. From Dr. J to Michael Jordan to Kevin Durant, who leads the whole league in scoring. It's Wayne Wade down in Miami, making a name. I love this game. To the NBA Hall of Fame. Slam dunk, Sally Oops, and the give and go. Vince Carter, Superman, and my man Carmelo and Rondo. Over in Boston with the big three. Captivating audiences across the country and ruling the world. Like LeBron the King, I say, man, Kobe sure has a lot of rings. That's my thing, not for the bling. Playing in the amount, it's the NBA Finals, so what's the count?
So once again, I want to thank you for tuning in to this week's show, WDC Radio. My man Jody's here. We're going to talk about living with sickle cell from childhood all the way up to today. He's going to share his story, and he's going to perform at the end of the show, so stay tuned for that. This is the second verse. This is my man Young Ice.
Tell me what's the count. Had Jerry run a route and Montana throw it out. At water make him sour when the back try to bounce. So I'm flipping through the channels as the Bulls wear them out. Trying to open 40 enemies, close mouth. So I'm ESPN and buried like a mouse. Scattered through the rivals, playoff idol. He'll make all enemies suicidal. Similar to Marshall Falk, a quick bouncer. Scatting on the fast, all you hear is the announcer. Then competition, so the crowd scream louder. Then he realized Roger Craig is a founder. So he sits on the defender around her. As Kareem, my dude, your boy hooks a mountain. Magic with a pass, so the Lakers straight clowning. All I want to know is homeboy, what's the count?
All right, so again, WC Radio, we're streaming live today. You can go to Atlanta Talk Live, New York Talk Live, and DC Talk Live, and you can catch the show right there. So we're streaming live. You can tune in right there on Ustream. You can check us out. This is the third verse, my man, IG, the Great.
I've been a fighter, greatest upset in history, noted the sports writer. Put me in the Olympics, I'm guaranteed I'm the torchlighter. Provider of all the lyrics that are blowing scorch fire. I'm in the locker room, getting my ass tamed. Thinking speed of a cheater, the strength of a man eight. I'm feeling bad what I'm about to do to this man face. But he the opponent, so I'm on the loss I can't take. Hands like Mayweather, swag like Ali. You think you way better, homie, than I see. And then I think they call me Hitman, Tommy Hearns. And y'all be biting like Tyson, I learn. And I don't gotta be flashy in front of the camera. All I do is show my warrior heart like you banned. Never been knocked out, but I've been knocked down. Long as I make it to the next round.
What's the count? All right, so let's get this show started. Like, my man Jody, I'm going to introduce. This is how we met. We met about 2 years ago at World Sickle Cell Day at a church. And I saw Jody earlier in the church. And then at the end of the service, they were going to do the blood drive. And they had an event going on. And there was a guy doing the interviews from the TV show. I think it was like Channel 7 News or something. They was doing interviews, and I was standing on the side, and I heard Jody's story, what he was sharing. And then I waited for my turn, and then Jody took off, and something was like, man, you need to go talk to that guy. And I was like, nah, I don't want to bother the guy. I don't want to bother him. So I got the courage, And I went inside and I was looking for him and I spotted him and I waved him across the room like, hey, can I talk to you for a second? And he came over and the rest is history. We connected like there are no mistakes in life. We know that. And truly God, we know that God put us together for a greater work for our sickle cell community. So, you know, it says that when two come in agreement, that's all it takes. And my man here, Jody's, since then, man, so that's June 19th, a couple years ago, we've been communicating like brothers, man, and just talking on how we can create this war on sickle cell and get it going and make a difference. And he actually had done some work in the early 2000s. He's a gospel rapper as well. He's going to share that with you. And he had been doing work before and kind of stopped. And I don't think he was going to be at the church that day either, right? Didn't you? You was in the
I wasn't going to show gonna up.
Go up, show up no. either, right? So we both was going to go show up, and here we are today. And so introduce yourself, man, to the listeners, man.
My name is Jody Johnson, born and raised south side of Chicago.
Chicago.
11 bros and sisters. I'm the only one that had the sickle cell disease. Everybody else has the traits. So I just always questioned my mom and God, why me? Why was I born sick with sickle cell? But it's all for a reason. You know, I'm just tired of seeing a lot of people dying. You know, we do a lot of events, we do a lot of fundraisers, but there's no change.
No change, right?
You know, I truly believe that the main cause is to share the story with people. That gives people hope. That gives people life.
And it educates people at the same time.
Exactly.
So let's start from the beginning. You said you had 11 brothers and sisters, all with the trait, and you were blessed with sickle cell disease.
Oh, man. Yeah, I was baptized.
So yeah. What was that like? Where are you at in the 11? Where are you at?
I'm the seventh. I'm the fifth brother.
Fifth brother.
Yeah.
So how was that back then?
I was diagnosed at the age of one, and I was always sick. I couldn't play like a normal kid. I was always up under my mom, and everybody else was outside playing in the snow, playing, and, you know, when it get hot in the summertime, we'll make a slip and slide in the basement.
Right.
And I couldn't even, you know, I tried playing. Every time I would try to play, I would give out. I would just fall out, would lose breath. I couldn't breathe, kept throwing up, and then taking me to the hospital. I remember twice my sister did CPR on me. I was like 5 years old.
Wow.
And I just didn't, now I understand why.
Yeah.
You know, I understand why through this battle, you know, we all here for a reason, you know.
Now, do you know if your parents knew they had this sickle cell trait? Do you know if they...
Actually, I questioned my mom about that. My grandfather, he died. He was 57 when he passed. And he had the disease. My mom and dad had the traits.
Wow.
Which is crazy. That's why I don't see how I passed everybody else up and just, bam, fell on me.
Yeah.
You know, I even got kicked out of school because of sickle cell.
Wow.
Yeah, because the kids didn't want to play with me because they said my eyes looked like alien eyes and they were scared to touch me. And that grew a complex on me for years.
I can imagine. Let's get to that. So how was it growing up in elementary school with sickle cell disease?
It was hard. It was real hard, especially when the wintertime come. I couldn't go to school for like 3 weeks. They would send my homework home to school. And I was always wanting to go to school and be with the kids, but I couldn't.
And you have sickle cell SC, right?
Right.
Okay, so you have SC. Now, being in the house and everybody's outside playing, what was that like for you? Like,
man, it was hard. It was torture. The only thing I could play with G.I. Joe and Kung Fu Girl.
So what was that your only outlet? Really, was it the playing with the
only? That was my mom and TV. You know, grew up on the old cartoons, Felix the Cat, and all of that. That was on my only outlet, but yeah. I tried to sneak out many times, but every time I did, it would backfire.
How far you get?
Man, just not even halfway on the swing. I'm sick. It was torture, but when we moved to California, it kind of changed a little bit.
Yeah.
A little bit for the better because of the weather.
The weather, yeah.
Yeah.
So you know that the cold, kind of cold weather, man, triggers yours for
triggers
sure.
It triggers the crisis, yes.
Yeah.
It triggers it big time.
So when you're in the cold, like, what are your
symptoms? Is like chest pains, a lot of pains in my bones and joints in my shoulders and my legs, feet, headaches. It's torture, man.
Yeah.
It's torture.
So as a young adult with sickle cell, mentally, how did you deal with that?
I was kept everything inside. It was like torture. It created a monster. I didn't know who to talk to. I just didn't know what to do because you confused at a kid. Like,
yeah,
you're always in and out of the hospital. You like, you don't know what to do. You don't know who to trust.
Yeah.
I didn't even trust my own body. So, you know, it was just torture.
Yeah.
You know, until I got the outlet was music. I started writing. That was my outlet.
That was your outlet, music? Yeah. What age was the music writing starting up?
15, yeah.
What was your first piece?
Actually, I did a gospel piece, man. A gospel song. It wasn't a rap song. It was a gospel song.
Like a
old Reverend C.L. Franklin. it was weird. I just started writing gospel songs.
Yeah. When did you, at what age did you touch into your spirituality?
I grew up in the church, but still, you know, anybody can grow up in the church, yeah. But I still did live my life, but my change really came in 1994.
Yeah.
That's the year I got married, and that's the year my wife led me to Christ.
Okay.
And that was the last time I was in the hospital with sickle cell complications.
Okay. We're going to bring that 1994 up in a second. Junior high school. What was living with sickle cell in junior high school? And you're in California by then, right?
I was in California.
So what was that like in California now?
I was trying to make friends. You know, I don't know if you remember Rodney Allen Rippey.
Yeah.
Yeah, I ran into him. Me and him became good friends. And, you know,
he was doing commercials back then.
Yeah, he was doing the Jack in the Box back then. And he kind of helped me. We were talking. We were playing together. I started playing kickball and baseball because the weather was cool.
Yeah.
You know, so it's really good weather here year round, you know, really to me.
Yeah.
So that kind of helped me, and I got into reading a lot. And
so your mental state kind of shifted?
Yeah, until I went to the doctor. I was 12 years old. I'll never forget it. I went to the doctor, and I heard my doctor tell my mom and dad, oh, he'll be lucky if he make 18.
Wow.
And I never shared that with my mom. I never told him I heard it. I just kept it within myself.
So what did you think when you hear the doctor tell your parents that? Like,
I really thought I had years. I really thought my life was numbered. So I was scared to go to sleep at night. I was always up. And that's when the guy started showing me a lot of dreams about future events, about my life. And I kept a lot of stuff inside. I never told my parents.
Yeah.
It was just something that God put in me, you know. And I knew I was here for a purpose. And I said, wow, I only got like 6 more years. You know, that's how I was thinking. Right. You know? And I was scared to go to bed. Even to this day, it's hard for me to sleep sometimes at nighttime. But I finally grew out of it. But you know,
why do you think you didn't share that with your parents? Were you afraid of something?
I didn't think they understood. I didn't think they was educated on sickle cell. Like, I wasn't educated. You know, the only thing I was used to getting, you know, which is weird. I didn't start taking meds until like 95.
Wow.
And my mom had her own remedies, you know, the hot towel. You know, she knew what to do to keep me, to give me comfort.
Yeah.
You know.
So let's talk about, because this guy Jody here is literally a walking miracle. Mm-hmm. What is your blood count? What's the count your blood? What do you tell them what you function off of?
Right now I function off of 5.3. Normally, for a normal person, what, 16?
Like, about for males, like 14. 14. About 14, females, like 12, somewhere around there.
And when I first got married up in 94, 95, I was like at an 8. And then as years went by, I was living off of, it never go beyond a 5.3.
So you understand that a 5.3 is like enough energy to barely sit up.
Stand up, yeah.
And watch TV. Like, literally just sit up. Yes. You have your normal energy level should be.
Yeah.
But yet you function and you move around.
I fly. I just flew from Miami. I go different
places.
Yeah,
we noticed the shirt. Yeah. We'll talk about the shirt later. All right. But, so 5.3.
So
that's and a lot of people that I've talked to in the community, when they get to a 5.8 or 9, they get transfusions.
Yeah, I haven't had a transfusion. I only have 2 transfusions in my life. And then the blood always came from my family because I didn't trust nobody else's blood but Christ's blood. That's it.
And we're going to talk about that blood,
yeah,
too.
But yeah, but it's a miracle. Even when I go to my doctor today, he's like, wow. All the nurses get scared. Like, when the blood comes in, the results, he's like, no, you guys don't understand this guy. This guy is a miracle. You know, he's a miracle. Don't panic. He's okay.
Yeah.
You know, so I know my limitations.
Yeah.
But I need to stop staying off these sodas. That's
scary. Yeah, we was talking about sodas earlier, my man over here drinking sodas.
I got to drink a lot of fluids, mostly water. Yeah. You know, I have a coffee every now and then, but like today, I was real tired and drained. You know, I do a lot of driving, but other than that, I know what to do to keep myself going.
Now we talked before. Being bullied is one of our conversations that we care about. A lot of people in the community experience, like you say, get teased.
Yeah,
that's a
bullied.
Form of lots of teasing and all. That's a form of bullying. What was that? What was that experience?
Yeah, I got
for you?
Bullied a lot. I'm not embarrassed to say it. Maybe it could help somebody else. I used to be so bullied to where I was scared to ask the teacher because I would use the restroom myself up until eighth grade because I kept being bullied. I didn't know who to talk to. And
so you wouldn't even raise your hand. You wouldn't even get up out of your seat.
I would just use the restroom in the classroom. You could see a long lake going down the floor in the room. I was just scared. Then one day I got tired. This guy kept taking my hats and, you know, kicking my seats and everything. So one day I just got fed up, turned around like the Incredible Hulk. I said, "You kick my chair one more time, it's on, brother." You know, that was it. I just started speaking up for myself.
And then
it kind of changed a little bit.
Yeah.
You know, until I got in high school. You know, when you see women and stuff, you like that changed your whole outlook.
So high school started kicking in. Then what?
I got into dancing. I got into dancing in my 9th, 10th grade.
Yeah.
I got into pop locking, and we auditioned for a couple of movies, B Street and Breaking. They picked us, but my brother never came back and got us. I'll never forget him for that. Never.
So you had to actually go.
Opportunity
to go to the Beat Street filming.
Yes.
And one of your brothers didn't pick y'all up to drop you off.
And which was weird. Dancing, I never got tired when I danced. Never got tired. I never got, because I used to love dancing. That was my outlet. I didn't think about sickle cell. You know, I got close to all my brothers. That made us closer.
Right.
You know, it's just having a big family, man. You're gonna have some that's gonna be jealous because you're getting that special love from your mom,
right?
And you're gonna have some that's gonna understand,
right?
Like I remember, I got sick on Christmas, and one of my brothers said, "Man, if Jody Diamond take all his toys," I said, "Man, that's cold blooded, man. That's dirty."
Like
man.
right there on Christmas.
Yeah, I used to be in the Hot Wheels, and I used to collect cars and stuff, and I had over 200 cars. You know.
Yeah. So he was ready. He was ready to collect.
He was ready to collect, man, like insurance.
That's wild. Yeah. So high school, what was high school like, man?
High school was pretty fun because I became a school favorite. I was they used to call me Shake. I used to always dance and at the pep rallies and stuff.
What?
Yeah, I was a good dancer. I was a real good dancer, and I did that for like 3 years, and I went to college for like 4 years.
Yeah.
When I got into college, I think I was 18. I did 4 years. I didn't know what my major was going to be, not knowing God had a calling on my life.
So
what I did to get relief, I would go to clubs.
Go
to clubs.
That's when it changed.
That's when it shifted to drinking, killing myself. I started drinking heavily for like 5 years. And I got in the hospital, and that was when my life started changing. From 91 up until 94.
So what was Jody doing in the club, man?
I was dancing, man. Chasing women, dancing and drinking. Yeah, that's what I did for years till I met my wife.
What was that like, man? I mean,
it was fun.
Were you sick still? Like what happened was
I started having a gallbladder attack. That triggered from sickle cell.
A lot of people
don't know gallbladder is from sickle cell crises.
Yeah, a lot of people have their gallbladder removed for sickle cell.
Yeah, and by me drinking, that made my gallbladder swell up, and my whole body turned like yellow, So I was in the hospital for like 7 days. I couldn't eat, I couldn't sleep, and when I found out I had to have surgery, I was like, oh, man. I was scared. I looked at my mom. I never forget. I wrote a song about it. I never forget this night. It was in November of 92. I said, "Mom," I said, "I'm going to die." And she looked at me. She said, "Don't say that." Because, you know, you're going to always be your mom's baby, no matter how old you are.
Of course.
You know? I said, "I'm going to die from this." And she looked at me. She started crying. I said, "I am going to die." And then she cried, you know. So after that, I woke up. I was coming didn't know they had took me in there, and I came to myself, and I woke up, and I seen my brother surrounding the bed, and it gave me comfort. And,
yeah.
And a week, 2 weeks later, I was back at the club with bags hanging out on me on my side at the club.
Doing your thing.
I still didn't get it, man. I still didn't get it, but.
What if not that we have favorite siblings, but who, which brother or sister were you mostly connected to?
I was mostly connected to my brother Leroy, which is Pastor Leroy right now.
Yeah.
And he was, me and him was hard heads going on. We was like Cain and Cain. Not Cain and Abel, just Cain and Cain. We did everything together. We was like partners in crime.
Wow.
Not knowing God had called him to preach and he called me to the ministry through music. And that's where we are today to fight this battle on sickle cell and everything. It's not easy.
Yeah.
You know, you get weary. You know, I think about Phyllis a lot. I never met her, but I've seen a story.
Yeah.
Recently, and it's her voice now.
Yeah.
You know,
that was my mentor, Phyllis Zachary Thomas,
yeah,
from the SCD Soldier Network.
Yeah.
And definitely you'll find out more about that in September. Sickle Cell Awareness Month is our month. So yeah, every Monday we'll have different topics on Sickle Cell Awareness Month. So yeah, now we're gonna take a quick break real quick, man. Before I go to break, though, what's your most memorable? You haven't been in the hospital that much. So what's your most memorable hospital experience? Was it the gallbladder removal? What?
When I got sucker punched and I had my whole jaw refractured because the dude got jealous because his girlfriend was dancing with me. I'm like, man, I don't want your woman, man. I'm just a dancer.
You're a dancer.
And that night he hit me, I was drunk. I didn't even feel a punch.
Wow. And,
you know, by having sickle cell, your bones are so fractured. You know, it's like.
Yeah, they're fragile.
My whole jaw just fractured. But that's another story, you know.
Yeah, I mean, we got a few minutes. What was that?
Man.
What was the results of that?
On his end or my end?
Both ends. Listen, okay. On your end. What
it
was your
basically reason? Like it was self defense. As soon as he hit me, because you know my brother was very overprotective of me, Leroy, Pastor Leroy.
Yeah.
When the guy hit me, the next thing I know, the guy went down. I my brother took on 12 of them by himself. He said, "Man, you hit my brother, man. My brother's sickle cell. He's sick and everything. You hit my brother, man." And next thing I know, bam, the dude was gone. I was in the hospital for like 2 weeks.
What?
Lost a lot of blood. I couldn't eat. I had to eat soup. My whole mouth was wired.
What?
And I had just got my whole mouth fixed and everything that same Monday.
What?
2 days later, I'm in the hospital again. I'm getting sucker punched.
And what was his outcome?
Yeah,
his outcome.
Rest in peace. He was in. It was like a lawsuit because the club refused to give me treatment. They didn't call an ambulance. And so what I did, I filed a suit. He was in a coma for like 6 months.
What?
But it was self-defense. He just hit me. He had on brass knuckles.
That's no.
He was like 6'3". I'm like 5'5".
Wow.
I was short at that time. So it was like, you know.
Yeah, of course.
So they've sided with me, you know. I mean, I think about the guy sometimes, but hey, you know, that's life, man.
Yeah.
Self-defense.
That's a serious experience right there.
Yeah.
So he ended up passing away.
And just think if I would have passed away, he'll still be here doing the same thing, bullying somebody else.
Right.
You know, so.
Wow. And your jaw's cool now?
Hmm?
Your jaw's cool?
Yeah, it's cool. Yeah.
Did you get a nickname out of that?
I can smile now.
No nicknames came with the glass jaw?
The women liked me more.
What?
Yeah, it was crazy, man. I met this.
They called you Cheeks?
Yeah. I was dating more around that time.
Cause you was a fighter then, man.
But yeah, all that just fell back on where we at today, man.
Yeah, that's cool, man.
Everything that's supposed to be bad, something good came out of it.
Right.
You know, that's how we're gonna do the sickle cell disease.
For sure, and we're gonna talk about that on the second half of the show. We're gonna take a quick break. This is WDC Radio. I got my man Jody here, man, sharing his story living with sickle cell. We're about to turn the tables and get to the positive aspects of sickle cell in your life experience and what you're up to today and our plan together, our movement that we've created as a team. And just let them know what we're up to. And then you're going to perform live, right?
Right.
So we're going to get that song together. So about 10 minutes before the show is over there in the corner, Jody DBC Johnson will be performing live. So we're going to be right back. Again, we're streaming live, Atlanta Talk Live, New York Talk Live, and DC Talk Live. So you can check us out there. This is LA Talk Live, reality radio, for more than just talk. We'll be right back.
Walk, run, climb, play. Solgar No. 7 can help. Feel the difference for yourself. Solgar No. 7 actually shows improvement in joint comfort within 7 days. Now you can start to get back on track fast and pursue the activities you love. Solgar No. 7 is a breakthrough in joint care with no glucosamine and no chondroitin. The advanced bioactives in Solgar No. 7 help to increase flexibility, mobility, range of motion, and actually shows improvement within just 7 days. One capsule, once a day, is all you need. When stiff joints occasionally say no, Solgar No. 7 says yes. Visit Solgar.com and learn more about Solgar No. 7 today. That's www.solgar.com, www.solgar.com. Solgar No. 7, official sponsors of Here's to Your Health with Josh Lane and LA Talk Live.
Hi, this is Susie Pruden. And yes, you've seen me on Oprah, Good Morning America, and The Today Show. And I'm inviting you to join me every Monday from 3 to 4 for my new show, Mastermind Live. Join us as we introduce you to the new thought leaders of the world who will inspire you, support you, and guide you to your next level. So don't forget to tune into Mastermind Live exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hi, this is Susan Levin, owner and founder of Speaker Services, inviting you to join me and co-host Jean Noel Bassiar on Monday evenings, 5 p.m. Pacific, for our new show, Talk Up Your Business, Speak Your Way to More Profits. We'll be talking to you about how to use your expertise to grow your business or service through speaking. Our expert speakers and author guests will share their stories and success secrets with you. Don't forget to tune in to Talk Up Your Business Mondays at 5 p.m. Pacific, exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream.tv. Reality radio handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
All right, welcome back. This is WC Radio. I'm your host. I am WDC, Faron. I got my man Jody here. We're going to talk, if you missed the first half, we were talking about him living with sickle cell from a child all the way up to he became Cheeks with the glass, with the brass knuckles. So let's talk about the spiritual aspect of what you're up to. Like, how does that play a part today?
It plays a big part because when I started, I started reading the Bible a lot, especially when I first got married. I got married in 94. That's when my eyes really came open to what we're doing now with sickle cell. I don't know if anybody remembers Josie Cook. She was one of the oldest ladies that I knew that had sickle cell. She passed away in 08.
Mm-hmm.
And she said I was the son that she never had. She got me involved into this.
Wow.
You know, she promoted all my concerts, and she had like 7 hip surgeries, and we did everything together. And when she died, it was like another mom got lost.
Yeah. You know?
So she got me in, and I got back into the church. I started doing music in the church, gospel rap. And then from that, you know, I start everywhere I go, share the sickle cell. When we talk about this, it's always based on God, because that's why I'm here. I mean, that's why I was born with sickle cell, all 11 kids. It was for a reason, to share and to be a blessing to somebody else that can't walk, that has surgery, that's always in a hospital, that has no hope. I didn't have hope before.
Yeah.
You know, I remember in the hospital, you know, I feel sorry for myself and nobody cares about me and everything.
Right.
But people do care.
Right.
You know, that's why we do what we do today. You know, and I didn't even know this was going to become a ministry.
Right.
But
I didn't either. Like, until meeting you and Phyllis, my mentor, who gave me the Judges chapter 4, Deborah and Barak, that a prophet gave her. And it's literally the blueprint for our work.
Exactly.
The message that we get to share with the community on the war on sickle cell. And it went, and the community wins in the end.
It's almost like a prophecy.
It's there. Like, you can find your life. They always say you can open up the Bible and find your life in there and work it and get it worked out.
I used to read like 4 hours a day, man. I forget what time it was. And every time I would read, I would fast, and then God would show me visions about what we're doing now. We're going all over the country sharing this story about sickle cell, you know, because in 1994, my life got changed through the word. You know, now I had something more to live for, extra.
Yeah.
You know, I didn't let the sickle cell beat me. I'm going to beat it.
Right.
By me not being in the hospital, it's 94. That's a miracle within itself.
And a 5.3. Like I said, most people as soon as it hits under a 6.
They go into the emergency room.
Emergency room, and transfusions take place and all, you know, stuff happens. Which is reality for some people.
Exactly.
You know, it's not every, sickle cell affects everybody different.
It does. You know?
But we're all related, because that's the relatedness of sickle cell. We have pain crisis, transfusions. What medications do you?
Man, sometimes I don't even take them. Man, I take like I have to have some Motrin or something mixed with it. It's like Vicomotrin or Dilaudid. I have medicines I don't even take, just sitting on the shelf, because I don't think I need it.
Yeah.
You know, as long as you take care of your body and eat right, which I'm trying. I'm not an expert in eating right, but
course.
I try. You
of
know?
Course.
And then I got my 2 girls. They make sure I take care of myself. And,
yeah.
You know, I just lost my wife a month and a half ago.
Yeah.
And there have been several of time I almost died, and she would pray for me and nurse me back to good health. Last year, I lost my father last April, and I flew to Chicago. When I came back, I had a major crisis.
Right.
But I didn't run to the hospital. I stayed at home. I couldn't eat. I threw up. But my wife made sure I ate soup and everything, nursed me right back to health through God's word, prayer, you know.
Right.
That's why I'm still here.
Right.
And when she died, man, that's another show there, man. That was my right side, you know, because she got me back in church. She had a lot of confidence in my ministry and what we do. And she's always was in our corner. You met her a couple of times.
A couple times, yeah.
Came over Thanksgiving, Christmas. Yeah, but we still going to win this fight, you know, even though she's gone naturally, but she's still here in the spirit.
Definitely. And that's what we did, you know, having that belief. Like, I always share with you, like, Star Wars, like, for me, Phyllis is like Star Wars and the Jedi Knights. When they were killed, they were more powerful in the spirit realm.
It's true.
And so that's how we relate to our losses, to those people that were close to us. in this war.
Yeah.
You know, that they're now we can pray and tap into the spirit world
Exactly. I can hear my wife telling me what to do. No, don't go this way. Don't move here. Do this. Go call this. I can just hear that through the spirit, through praying. I lost my mom, my dad, my wife. She lost her mother, her father. Same pattern.
Yeah.
But the fight is still going to go on. If I die today or tomorrow, my kids is going to carry on because it'll never die.
Right.
Because we're going to always have somebody in the battlefield.
Right.
You know.
So on the spiritual aspect of it, we got so much to share. You just came from Florida.
Mm-hmm.
What was that like? Man,
Florida was awesome, man. I met Apostle JW.
Shouts out to JW, man.
Man, that's a good brother.
Wow.
Good brother, man. Brother is powerful.
Yes.
Powerful. Just listening at him make you just want to be with him, you know, join his ministry.
Exactly.
You know, I was, what happened was that when I first got there that Saturday, it was a young lady that got killed unjustly in 08, and they was doing a march in her honor.
Yeah.
So I spoke and I done something there. And then the next day I spoke at my brother's church, and then Pastor JW, anniversary. It was really nice. You know, I shared the story on sickle cell and I did a couple of songs, and they want us to come back in September.
Now, what was crazy when we met J-Dub like the week before, man. You know, the lady that you marched for, her name was Deborah.
Exactly.
That's when I shared with him about the whole Deborah and Barack and the, man, it was like
pieces connected.
Exactly.
Because before I even went a year ago, I had a dream that I was in Florida, and there was a little baby ran up to the altar at the church. And if that did not happen, I am not sitting here.
It happened when you was there?
When I was up doing the song, a little baby ran up to the altar.
What?
Yes.
And you had that vision?
Yes, 6 months ago. Yes. That's why I know everything we do is not in vain, you know, because God said he's the beginning and the end. So we just really going through the emotions of life.
Wow.
You know, this life to me, it's really, you know, it's kind of hard to explain, but yet I understand what the word says.
Right.
He's the beginning, Alpha, Omega, the beginning and the end, which is true. You know, he already knew us in the womb. He already knew I was going to be born with sickle cell.
Exactly.
Yeah, you're going to be persecuted for my name's sake. You're going to have to be sick. You know, I'm like, why me? And I'll never forget not going back to that, but I'm going to say this to say that. I had, I was drinking. I was real drunk one time. This is a true story. This is in 91. 2 o'clock in the morning, I had threw up. I woke up. I had an out-of-body experience, man.
Wow.
I literally seen myself. I was like, you know better. This is not what you're supposed to be doing. It was like, an angel or God or something was talking to me as I was throwing up. And I was looking up at myself. And if that didn't happen, man, I'm serious.
You're a powerful guy, man.
Man, I'm serious. And I can share some things, man, that'll take up the whole show.
Yeah,
man.
But that's part of our ministry, our work.
Right, exactly.
That we get to create in our community to mm-hmm. share our message, because it's important, and it is a ministry. It is a form of ministry.
Yeah, I always wonder how long sickle cell's been around, you know? I could think about that a lot. You know, back in the Bible days, did they have to deal with what we going through? You know?
Yeah.
And put it all together. Just like AIDS, if they can fight and do AIDS foundations and diabetes and everything, even all that runs in my family. But sickle cell is the forgotten disease that they don't want to touch. I don't know if they're afraid of it. They don't know how to diagnose it. What is it? It got to be powerful for them to be tiptoeing around it.
Exactly.
You know, so we got to be the ones to educate the world on what sickle cell really
is. My thing is create the conversation and let the people, like you say, sharing your message, sharing your story is powerful.
Yeah.
It frees you up. It educates people around you. And you get connected and you realize that I'm not the only one dealing with the illness.
I had met a Hispanic brother with sickle cell, and a Caucasian lady. She was like 53. I said, "You have sickle cell?" She lives in Arizona right now. I'm like, wow, it's just not a black disease. It's a disease of
it's inherited.
Even Indians. I met an Indian that have sickle cell.
Yeah.
And she's doing pretty good. Yeah. So.
And that's what that message we get to bring. And so what do you want the world to know about sickle cell? Like, what do you want them to know?
What I want them to know, when they see a fundraiser, or if they see anything, you know, that's showing anything about sickle cell, ask questions about it. Don't be afraid. Don't be afraid to call in, or don't be afraid to come up to anybody that you know that has sickle cell. If you know somebody in your family that has the traits, it's the same thing. You know, that's how it starts.
Yeah.
You know, if they marry somebody that has the traits, then their genes.
There's a 1 in 4 chance.
Their kid's going to have sickle cell, which is weird. I have 2 daughters. The youngest have the traits, and the other one, she's just anemic.
Yeah.
I'm like, well, how is that possible?
Right.
You know, but I'm just thankful. I always want to be a part of what I'm doing. I'll die doing this. This is what I believe in. This is why I'm here. I never give up, no matter how tired. I do get tired a lot, but I still got to stay in this race.
Yeah.
Because the race is not given to the strong, but to those that can endure.
Right.
And we've been enduring, brother, huh?
Hey, we've been enduring. We've been doing this work, you know, on our own, and we're definitely looking for sponsorship, for people to donate to the cause. I've created my nonprofit, and like I said, I have the media packet that has Jody here as my partner, and if it's just you and me, man, at the end of the day, that's what we're going to do.
We're going to stand.
It's a life or death situation, man. It's
we're going to hold up the flag on top of the hill like the soldiers did. Like on what, Hiroshima?
What was you, did you had dreams of?
Man, I always wanted to go into the Air Force, man, since I was like 10 years old.
Yeah.
And I didn't know. I forgot all about the sickle cell. That's the only thing that stopped me from going in. But I heard this brother last week.
Well, yeah, he was on the show Trench Talk last Saturday.
How did
Marine
he get
Corps.
Into the Marines? And I was jealous. I'm serious. Because I always wanted to join an organization that's fighting for something.
Yeah.
Which I am in now. Fight for sickle cell.
Yeah.
You know, so I consider myself being in the Air Force.
Yeah, we definitely soldiers. I got some camouflage for you. I'll get you some camouflage for you. I don't know about painting the face though, but I can get you some gear.
Yeah, I already got the boots.
I got some gear for you, so we can definitely do that. But man, what do you think? What's most important? Like when you go out in the community and share about sickle cell, like what's your voice? I know I have my view of what it is, but what's your view?
What makes me real happy when I share my story with somebody, especially a little kid, and they just. You can see a smile on their face. You know, when we went to Vegas a couple of years ago, it was a couple of kids in there that had the disease. And then when we came back, the young girl had got married. She didn't think she could have got married with sickle cell.
Yeah.
But by us being there sharing our stories, they gave her hope to get married. So that gives me hope because she never gave up. The kids never give up. No matter how old you are, never give up. Because we all help us one to another.
Yeah.
You know, we fighting the same battle, you know. I'm working on a song right now, a sickle cell song, red cells versus white blood cells. But that's my joy, man, just being a part, just being there.
Yeah.
Even if I don't have to say nothing, man, I'm just glad I came. If I could pass out a flyer, I'm doing something, you
definitely,
know.
Definitely, definitely. So you about ready to get this performance, man. On, man?
Yeah, I'm ready to rock the house.
You ready to rock the house, man? What, man... I've been waiting for you to come on these shows. Like when I had the WDC, you would call in on the sports show. We would talk sports and stuff. But I want to thank you, man, for coming here and really doing this show and sharing who you are, man.
I had to come, man, because I'm always out this way in LA, in Long Beach. So I had to come, man. And I just thank God that I came. I thank God that I'm here. And I'm working on some music right now. This is my 9th CD that's coming out. I'm thinking about changing the name, dealing with sickle cell. So we're just going to keep it moving. Y'all pray for us.
Definitely. Give them your information so in case somebody wants to donate to the cause or want to reach out to us so we can get some sponsorship going here. Because I'm retiring next month and the nonprofit's getting in place and we're definitely going to need some support from the community to do this work.
Well, they can hit me up 3 ways. DBC_123@yahoo.com, or you can call 562-612-8514, or you can Twitter me at DBC Jody, and then I'll get all your information. Anybody want a CD? Anybody want to hit us up? Anybody wants to come out?
You had a sponsor before.
Yeah, like, I was with Food for Less for a while, but yeah. I'm gonna get back in that, you know, again, and then we're gonna see what we can do from that.
And your contributions will help us continue further our work here on the radio show and in the community. Cause that's what we dedicated the rest of our life to do, man. All across the country, create this platform, create our programs, and share our information and educate.
Yeah, exactly. Like we saying, we're not trying to push no other organization to the side. We just want to be heard.
We position ourselves to partner with others because we talk about trait disease and we have our stories.
Exactly. It's not easy. That's why we still here. People dying every day from sickle cell. Even stress is killing people. You know, I know a mother that got all of her kids got sickle cell, and she's on the verge of a breakdown because she don't have no help.
Right.
That's why we do what we do, you know.
All right. And if you want to follow me, I'm at IMWDC on Twitter. You can hit me up at WDCONSCD@gmail.com. You can send the information there. I have a media packet for us ready to go. We ready to get busy. We ready to take on the community. We ready to check out Judges chapter 4. It's our purpose, Deborah and Barak. And JL and how the community wins in the end when she kills Sisera with the tent peg.
So we're going to keep on doing it. I'm going to just get ready to do this song.
All right.
Praise him.
All right. We're going to take a quick break. We're going to get the mic set up. And coming up in a few minutes, DBC is live in the building performing. So we'll be right back. Oh, Lord. What'd you say? You already praying already?
No, I'm ready.
All right, we'll be right back. WC Radio, LA Talk Live.
Hi, this is Jean Noel Bassior, inviting you to join me for my new show, The Book Beat, Monday evenings at 6:30 p.m. I'll be talking to authors about their latest book, so you can find a fantastic read. But more than that, I'll be talking to experts about how you can write your own book and get it published. So tune in on Mondays at 6:30 p.m., exclusively on LATalkLive.com. And remember, you can catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV. Reality Radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hi, this is Bernice Heron inviting you to join me every Tuesday at 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time for our all-new show, The Mortgage Show. Join us as we discuss exclusive new products and programs through government and conventional financing. No mortgage-related topics are spared. Come with me through this journey of informative, stimulating conversation, giving you the facts, clarity, and insight you deserve. You never heard a mortgage show like this before. You'll be enlightened, educated at the same time. This is for the community, for the nation, for everyone. As the industry evolves, we evolve. So don't forget to tune into The Mortgage Show, 3 p.m. Pacific Standard Time, exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or just watch us on Ustream TV. Reality Radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we're more than just talk.
Hey, what's up? It's your girl,
Forbidden Gem,
inviting you to join us every Tuesday night at 9 p.m. sharp for the hottest, livest talk show, Forbidden Tuesdays.
Join us as we expose the new generation of love and dating and help y'all run a game right. Ladies, beware. Fellas, bring out your notepads.
So don't forget to tune in to
Forbidden Tuesdays
exclusively on LATalkLive.com. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream TV. This is
LA Talk Live,
and we are more than just talk.
You ready?
Hi, this is Elena, inviting you to join me every Wednesday at noon for Elena's Beauty Talk and more, exclusively on LA Talk Live. You can also catch us on iTunes Radio R&B or watch us on Ustream.tv. Reality Radio, handcrafted for your listening pleasure. This is LA Talk Live, and we are more than just talk.
Hello world, how you living? This is Dee Brex, your host of the all-new Rap Project here on LA Talk Live. That's latalklive.com. Or you can find me on iTunes Radio in the R&B section. That's the Rap Project every Wednesday at 7 p.m. Pacific Standard Time. That's Wednesdays at 7 p.m. West Coast Time. So don't be late. On the Rap Project, I will be playing the very best of rap and hip-hop that goes beyond the ordinary. So connect with me, your host, D-Brax, the Rap Connoisseur, on The Rap Project every Wednesday at 7, right here on latalklive.com, where we are more than just talk.
All right, the moment that you've been waiting for. My man Jody is here live performing one of his tracks on stage here live on LA Talk Live. All right, Jody, you ready, man?
Ready.
All right, let's go.
Can you hear me? Testing, testing.
Check
right,
one,
I'm
two.
Ready, I'm ready.
All right, here we go.
Oh, don't tell him I gave you the wrong track. That's not the right track.
Reality Radio.
That's the wrong disc, I told you. Can we
get a station identification break? All right, we're going to be right back. We're going to get this together. It's real. It's live.
It's all good.
All right, we're back. We got this together now. Once again, aka Jody DBC is here performing live.
Driven by Christ.
Driven by Christ.
Yeah, that's it.
There we go. He's ready now.
Yeah, here. A little long, yeah.
Jesus.
Yeah, that's it right there.
Yeah.
To the words, not to the tracks. It's about Christ, not beats and hypes. Clap your hands, stump your feet. Shout to God, he's so unique. Praise our calling for the upright. Stop blessing God both day and night. Ain't no rock gonna take my place. Praise him till sweat fall from face. Throw your hands up in the air. Praise him, y'all, anywhere. Praise the Lord with whole heart. Bless his name, you come too far. Let him stare. I don't care. He saved my soul. Can't you hear? Sing to him a new song. Don't feel bad, you done no wrong.
Throw your hands up in the air. Yeah.
Praise God like you
just don't care.
Throw your hands up
in the air. Praise.
Give God the praise.
Let them all stare.
Throw your hands up
in the air. Yeah.
Praise God like you
just don't care. Throw your hands up in the air. Praise. Give God the praise. Let them all stare.
And Dio, Lord, I put my trust in time of trouble. Don't give up. Truly, God is all good. Put your hands up, not for no hood. Head of the Lord, should submit. If you don't praise, you need to quit. No big eyes, little you. Praise them all for your breakthrough. Bless the people, know the sound. Sing and dance, yo, a chow. Don't be ashamed to bless his name. People gon' talk anyway. All to the good, give him thanks. Strong or weak, don't you faint. He is God, reign forever. Highest praise, I'm gon' give him.
Throw your hands up in the air. Yeah.
Praise God.
Like you just don't care.
Throw your hands up
in the air.
Praise. Give God the praise.
Let them all stand. Throw your hands up in the air. Yeah. Praise God like you just don't care. Throw your hands up in the air. Praise. Give God the praise. Let them all stand.
Clap your hands, all you people, shout to God. We are equal, great is he to be praised. Thank you, Lord, you loose your chain. Bring forth all praise. Yes, God, I obey. Woke me up, my mind on him. Made me whole, cleanse all sin. Pass the spark with the flock. How many gon' bless the rock? Come and see his mighty works. Time is now, let's have some church. Hold my soul
in his hand.
Split the sea.
Made dry land.
Yes, we serve a mighty God. Praise him now, it ain't that hard.
Throw your hands up in the air. Yeah.
Praise God.
Just don't care.
Throw your hands up
in the air.
Praise. Give God the praise.
Let them all stand. Throw your hands up in the air. Yeah.
Praise God.
Like you just don't care.
Throw your hands up in the air.
Praise.
Give God the praise. Let them all stand. Give them praise.
Give them praise.
Give them praise now.
Give them praise.
Give them praise.
Give them praise
now. Give them praise.
Give them praise.
Give them praise now. Give them praise.
Give them praise.
Give them praise now. Give them praise.
Give them praise.
Give them praise, y'all.
Give them praise. Give them praise. Give them praise.
Y'all.
Give them praise. Give them praise.
Give them praise, y'all.
Give them praise.
Give them praise.
Give them praise.
Throw your hands up in the air.
Yeah.
Praise God like you just don't care. Throw your hands up in the air.
Praise.
Give God the praise.
Let them all stand. Throw your hands up in the air. Yeah.
Praise God like you just don't care. Throw your hands up in the air.
Praise.
You got the praise, let them all stand.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
I can't sing, y'all. I ain't gonna even try.
I will bless the Lord at all times. His praises shall continually
be. Yes, y'all, give God the praise.
I will bless the Lord at all times.
Bless his name at all times. His praises shall continually be in my mouth. God bless you. WDC.
Hey, DVC.
Oh,
man, come on back and sit down, man. We got like 2 minutes. Well, you ain't nervous, man. That's all natural, man. I'm nervous on the show like first 15, 10 Woo. Minutes.
All right.
Man, thank you, man.
Oh, man. You know, I love music, man.
How you feeling, man?
I feel good.
Feel good?
Feel great.
Still tired?
No, I'm not tired. Was earlier. Probably 2 hours ago.
Yeah.
No, I'm all right, man. It's what I love doing, man. We keep it real. Mistakes or not.
Exactly. It's live.
It's live, man. So we keep it live. Keep it real. We keep it pushing. We keep it moving.
What do you want the world to know about Jody, man?
What you see is what you get. I love praising God. I love being active in the community. I love taking care of my girls. I just love doing what I do, you know? So anybody that want a CD, like I say, hit us up at Twitter, DVC at Twitter. I mean, DVC at... What's my Twitter account,
man? Twitter is DVC
underscore. I'm tired,
DVC
y'all.
At DVC Jody. All right, hey, we just want to thank you, man. Thanks again for coming, man, and sharing your story.
Anytime, man.
He'll definitely be back. This is my partner in crime right here. We out in the community doing work. If you want to catch up with us, text the word trait to 41242. That's my text number, and you'll get a message back, and you'll be able to follow us through the community, because we're coming out there in a city near you, doing our work, sharing our stories, doing our ministry. And
next we're gonna have our daughters come.
We got another trait advocate over here that's over here in the background.
She's trying to stay in the cut, but she got a lot to talk about.
Yeah, we'll get her next time.
We'll get her.
Jody, again, thank you, man, for coming on the show, man. And this is your home. This is your platform, man. This is your platform too. So,
what's the count?
Shout us out. What's the count? WC Radio. We'll be back next week. Oh, you definitely want to tune in on next week's show. I got Christopher E. Pierman coming back. I got Raven Simone's dad. We're going to do some motivational speaking next week, so he'll be back. Look for the posting. WDC Radio.
Peace out.
LA Talk Live.
Peace.
No longer live now.
That was tight, though. I'm glad we got through it.
Thank you.
Where that marker at?
Sport. You know I like the way the dribble up and down the court, fast and slow. 25 years ago to WDC and it's me, your man Curtis Blow. From Dr. J to Michael Jordan to Kevin Durant, who leads the whole league in scoring. It's Wayne Wade down in Miami, making a name. I love this game, to the NBA Hall of Fame. Slam dunks, alley-oops, and the give and go. Vince Carter, Superman, and my man Carmelo and Rondo. Over in Boston with the big three, captivating audiences across the country and ruling the world. Like LeBron the King, I say, man, Kobe sure has a lot of rings. That's my thing, not for the bling bling in the amount. It's the NBA Finals, so what's the count?
Me, what's the count? Had Jerry run a route and Montana throw it out. At water, make him sober when the back try to bounce. So I'm flipping through the channels as the Bulls wear them out. Drowned over 40 enemies, closed mouth. So I'm ESPN, they bury like a mouse. Scattered through the rivals, playoff idol. Here make all enemies suicidal. Similar to Marshall Falk, a quick bouncer. Scatting on the fast, all you hear is the announcer. Then competition, so the crowd scream louder. Then he realized Roger Craig is a sounder. So he sits on the defender around her. As Kareem, my dude, your ball hooks a mountain. Magic with a pass, so the Lakers straight clowning. All I wanna know is homeboy, what's the count? And
greatest upset in history, noted the sports writer. Put me in the Olympics, I'm guaranteed I'm the torchlighter. Provider of all the lyrics that are blowing scorch fire. I'm in the locker room, getting my hands tamed. Thinking speed of a cheetah and strength of a man, eight. I'm feeling bad what I'm about to do to this man's face. But he the opponent, so I'm on the loss I can't take. I'm hands like Mayweather, swag like Ali. You think you way better, homie, than I see. And then I put the call me Hitman, Tommy Hearns. And y'all be biting like Tyson, I learn. And I don't gotta be flashy in front of the camera. All I do is show my warrior heart like Evander. Never been knocked out, but I've been knocked down. Long as I make it to the next round, what's the count?
This is SCTG on WC Radio. You are now listening to What's the Count Radio. Stay tuned for more information on LA Talk Live. We are more than just talk.